What's going on, guys? Today I decided that I would take my own advice for Bellator. In my Bellator video, I don't know if you guys remember it, I made a video of what Bellator should do to make their product more intriguing and better for 2020. And I said in one of the topics listed, I said that they should start their own ranking system. So today I said to myself, hey, why don't I do what I asked Bellator to do for them and make it into a playlist of videos for you guys to then judge. And then we could take a look at them even throughout the year and see how they change month to month maybe. And then when we're looking forward to big fights, we can look back and take from the rankings and see where the matchups play out. If he's fighting somebody that no one knows, if he's fighting somebody that I think is in the top 15 ranks of Bellator, we can go about it. We can go about it through that way, and it just adds a little bit more interest and a little more intrigue to some of these Bellator matchups. So for this video, I decided I was going to start with welterweight because I think that if you're going to compare divisions, I think the best division that Bellator has to offer is their welterweight division. Now, here is my 16-man, including champion, ranking. So, we obviously have the champion, Douglas Lima, who's fought 17 times for Bellator and holds the gold. In the last half decade, he has redeemed both his losses in Bellator to both Koreshkov and Rory McDonald, most recently winning the welterweight Grand Prix and what come with it, a world title. Now, at number two and number one, I was arguing with myself here. Who do I have where? Now, I think John Fitch has put in more to MMA throughout his career and Bellator specifically. John Fitch and Michael Venom Page have both fought Paul Daly. One of them went to an extremely close and extremely controversial decision in the welterweight Grand Prix, and one of them thoroughly dominated them in their matchup, being John Fitch. So I decided to put Fitch number one and Michael Page number two, even though I think Venom Page will probably be the next welterweight to get a shot at Douglas Lima that will really pose a significant threat to Douglas Lima's belt, even though Lima has already finished Michael Venom Page once before. Now, the rest of my list kind of goes as the Grand Prix did. You have Paul Daly, because Paul Daly's been through the rings at Bellator. I have Neiman Gracie, who put up a great effort against Rory McDonald in the Grand Prix. Then Ed Ruth, Lorenz Larkin. And Lorenz Larkin, who slept on a little bit throughout the division. Larkin has beaten the likes of Jorge Masvidal in the UFC, Santiago Ponzinibbio in the UFC. He's a legit welterweight, and I have him in at number six in the welterweight rankings. It goes to show you how good Bellator's welterweight division. Then you have the undefeated Yaroslav Amosov. Amosov's next fight is against Ed Ruth, and I expect big things for him to make maybe a jump up in my own rankings. He's undefeated, 22-0. I just thought he hadn't done enough at this point to put him in the consideration with some of the guys that they included in the Grand Prix. For the rest of the Bellator rankings, I really did try to just fit it in best possible, looking at results, looking at who they fought, because Eric Silva has fought some of the best, even though he hasn't really strung together many wins in Bellator. I have Logan Storley, Joey Davis, Stefano Paterno, Simon, Ashley Reese, and Oliver Onkamp. You guys let me know in that range, do you guys agree with the rankings? And even from through 1 through 15, do you guys agree with how I have the rankings set up? Would you change anything? Would you put anybody anywhere else? We can have a discussion in the comment section below. And then maybe I'll alter it come the second edition of whatever ranking we do next. And I'm going to look to these rankings in the future throughout 2020. So make sure you take a look at these videos and the rest of the videos that are going to be coming out. Because not only are they fun and they're a concept that we can all engage in and all have a voice in, but there's something that's going to organize some of the Bellator fights for you and maybe make them way more interesting. But as for the welterweights, that wraps up the ranking video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be on the lookout for the featherweight division, which I have coming up next in the very near future. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed, remember to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and keep notifications on. But that will do it for me today. Peace out, guys.